process. Okay, just
Yes.
hold on. Who else is there? Yashaswini Rupam, what happened to your installation process?
Sir, I still have the same problem. Like, I'm
Okay,
not
can
able
you
to
just
run the scripts.
share your screen if it's possible from your side?
Yes, sir. I log in with my laptop and share the screen, sir. I have to
Okay.
run the program, so I'll take 2 minutes, sir.
Okay, no problem. You just carry on. Carry on.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
And there is one doubt regarding the assignment question. Something the doubt is related to this. Let me share my screen. I hope you are able to see this, see my screen.
No, sir.
Not it? Just hold on. I'm already in the presentation mode. So a dialog box has come that I cannot share my screen. But anyway, again, one second, I'm trying. Yeah, I think now it will start.
Yeah, it's starting.
Okay. So one doubt is related to the, according to my. The question is related to question number 8, assignment 3. The participant should give choice for accommodation for provided for hotels and services. Okay. Okay. I think Sagiruddin is not there now. Anyway, his selection of those will be any one of this one of the hotel choices. So he's going on the right track, no problem. Exactly, he's now entered. Right, Sagiruddin, are you online? Okay, anyway, even if he comes back, we'll discuss with him about this question. He's one of the assignment question only. I think the others may are able to clear with this Sagiruddin Akhtar's question. It is related to the VAMP installation. There are some issues for some of the students. Regarding to the quiz 9, okay, this anyway, the date is extended. And for others, I think some of them, the installation issues, I already addressed to them. Anyway, if anybody is having any questions, we can post it now. You can ask it through this session, or you can just post it your questions on the chat session. Sagiruddin Akhtar. Yeah. Sagiruddin Akhtar, your doubt is yes, whatever you are. Design your web page for those hotel selection and the services that remains the same. So here you have selected the hotel and the corresponding different types of services. Yes, you can enable. So whenever you design web pages, obviously it's the features. So whenever you want to incorporate certain features, whether you have to go for a a drop down list, or whether you want to go for a checkboxes or whether you want to go for a dialog boxes. So you have to always make sure that your user interfaces are very convenient, and it should be very easy to understand for the users. So it should not be like according to you or your taste and your requirements. So a user interface, that's what we always look for. A graphical user interface should be very much user friendly. So what features you are going to incorporate, whether you're going to put drop boxes or whether you are going to put check boxes, you can keep it. What are the features, whether you want to go for radio buttons, you can keep those features, but make sure that user has been having a clarity in complete aspects. You should know, user should not be confused at any state. So that should be one of the design goal of a web page or any user interface in simple terms. So you can choose anyone, is up to you. So since this is a beginner classes for the web pages, so we make you to understand how best you can design your user interfaces. So one of the design goal of your user interface is also to make the interface to be flexible, very easy to understand, and very easy to navigate from one component to another component and from one web page to another web page. So these things are the basic things. Basically, you will learn more clearly on the software engineering course. But for this, especially for this web applications, the internet technologies, to understand the features of various user interface controls, you can keep whatever the features is, because you have to learn all the features. That's what you, if you cannot learn all the features, at least to maximum extent, you should be able to understand the controls, the components, and the features very easily. So we give it to you only. That's what we don't want to put our the output should look like this. That's the question. Mostly some questions will be there, some questions will not be there. The output form should be having this. So it is up to your design how best you can put your controls, I mean to say that components or the features of your web interfaces. That is what the point to be understood here. Yeah, are you clear with this doubt, Sagiruddin? He's on and off, I think. Okay. Any other doubts, please? Okay, maybe he's facing some network problem. No problem. When he comes back, I will be in touch with him. Sir, can I share the screen? Yes, Ashaswini Rupa, yeah, please share the screen. Let me just check if I can solve it quickly. We'll complete it now within a few minutes. Otherwise, we'll see at the end of the session. So let me just check immediately what is the main issue. Please share your screen, no problem. I have revoked my, yeah, now you can see. Yes, yes.
So are you able to see it?
Yes, yes, yes. I am able to see it. And others are also able to see it. Okay.
Now, okay. If I'm.
Yeah, you have entered the username and the password. Okay. You're clicking the login button, right?
I'm getting these errors, sir.
Okay. Okay. One second. Look into this. See, these are the warnings, of course. From the PHP parser, these are the warnings. Usually you find it. So if you can see the line number 8 of connect.php, can you open your editor and go to the line number 8?
Okay, sir. Sir, if I were using
yes,
MariaDB database instead, and if we have to write this connection file in PHP, then we have to write different commands, different syntax.
See here. Yeah, you are a very good question at this time. Basically, when you are using MariaDB or that SQL connections will be there. So those are basically methods. Those are called functions. So those functions may be slightly different, but logically same. syntactically different, but logically they are going to be, the meaning of the methods and the functions are going to be the same. So what I suggest to you is, it is always a good habit to see what are all the valid features or available features. So I am just showing you. You always okay, Sushma.
Okay, sir. I'll take
it. No, no, no. Hold on, hold on. No problem. No problem. Keep it like that. Keep it like
okay.
that.
Okay. This.
So see, always those who are present in the session, very important point. Just kindly look into my screen. So whenever you are learning a new programming language or something like similar to database servers and all, you should always get an acquaintance to how to understand the documentation of that software. So the documentation of that software is going to be giving you how, what are all the features of that software is providing. So here, any, please look into this, any software, they have the corresponding websites will be there. They keep on updating their those documents. It means their new versions of their softwares have new set of commands, new set of methods, new set of tools will always will be there. So as a software developer or as a programmer or as a web developer, you also should get acquainted to what is the new functions the new versions are supporting. So your mind should also tune to that particular set of practice. It's not that all you might have learned some command, you might have learned some method in your olden days, and you don't think that the same command, same method will be useful forever. No. So the software versions keeps on updating. They upgrade their products very frequently. So the best method is always, you should have an habit of looking to see this documentation will be there for any software. Either you, if you, this is your MariaDB documentation. So that documentation will give you what are all the set of things that are need to be understood by the user of that particular software. So similarly, you have MySQL. MySQL also will have the corresponding documentation. So the MySQL.com, if you go to their websites, so now again, the documentation is going to be there. So all the softwares, major software, give their documentation. Yes, sir.
Am I showing something? I think screen is not yours.
Okay.
Okay, I'll stop sharing for now, sir.
Okay, I'll come back to that point later. Okay, you are stopped. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Is my screen visible to you?
Yes, sir. Anyone screens are like, we can view both of us.
Are you able to see both of my screens? Means both of the users?
Yes, sir. We can pin anyone's we want, sir. Like, if you want to see yours, then we can pin yours.
Now, are you able to view my screen, please? Is it okay, sir?
Yeah, your screen is
so here, that's what I was telling just now. So the softwares, they have their own websites. This is the MariaDB .org website. In the website, you have a feature, means you will have a tab or something, a hyperlink with there, which gives you something called documentation. Similarly, in the MySQL, you'll have something called, again, all the software, the major softwares, they keep on updating their softwares. They keep upgrading. Updating, there's a small difference is there between upgrading and updating. So both the things will happen for the softwares. New versions of the softwares will come. So as a programmer or as a developer, as an IT professional, always make sure that you also need to understand how you can look into these reference manuals. See, if you see which version of MySQL you are using. If you're using MySQL 5.7, this is a reference manual. MySQL 5.6, this is a reference manual. MySQL 8.0, this is a reference manual. So depending on the version, there will be corresponding methods, corresponding functions will be different. So always make sure that you are trying to, which version of the software you're using and what are the permissible functions or the permitted statements. So you have a tutorial here for the MySQL. You can easily go to those tutorials and try to understand how you can write your queries, how you can write your programs to this. So sample programs are also there here. So using this is all MySQL program. Similarly, you go to MariaDB, you can go to getting started. So there you have a simple presentation and videos, the books are there. So this is comments, whatever the comments you're seeing, a list of SQL statements the MariaDB is supporting to us. So these data definition, like creating the table, dropping the tables, if you are modifying your table, that is using the alters. So these are DDL commands, DML commands. Like similarly, you have DCL commands, control language commands. So you can see how you can use those particular commands here. So most likely those commands will be the same, MariaDB and MySQL. The syntaxes are going to be the same, but only for the connections will be slightly different there. So the whatever the methods, these are this is what select star from something like that, the SQL statement which you give here. So always it's a good habit to refer to this kind of documentation, the or the tutorials which are given in this official software websites. So please have an habit of referring to those official websites of those softwares. Look to the current version and look for your commands, whatever you're looking for. So the question here is, if you're connecting to this MariaDB, so like this, something like MySQL command you are going to look for. So MySQLi underscore connect, I'm going to the search button here and I'm typing, I'm just entering MySQL connect command. So if at all you get the MySQL connect command, how that command is going to give, what is the syntax for this one? You may get, of course, so much of information which you think that may not be needed for you at this moment. So you can just go to those command syntaxes. Just you go to that web. 1 second, hold on. List of useful MariaDB queries. So the small changes will be there, among like this, the create command is there here, inserting. These commands remains the same, the DML, the DDL commands, most likely 99% will be the basic SQL commands will be the same. But only in the connection commands, like MySQL connect, or when you are running the query of that prepared statement of the database. So those small changes will be there. So you can refer to those commands, what these softwares are giving from the documentation of that website. So that's what you need to understand here. Who is the question? Question is asked by Amruta, right? Yeah. So, yeah. So Ashwin, can you please share the screen, your screen? Let me just quickly check once. And I'll come back to that comments again. I'm just stopping from my side. Hold on. Okay.
So this is the connect.php file.
Okay, you're using MariaDB or you're using
MariaDB, sir. I'm not
able to Okay. Just go to your WAMP that's on your. Can you show me your WAMP server?
Yes, sir.
Ah, it is in orange. It is not running there.
Yes, sir. It's always in orange.
Ah. It's always orange. It is not running here for you.
Okay. Yes, sir. Uh-huh. Actually, I have MySQL installed before, so I guess that
same might problem. Be. The same problem even Amruta has done earlier. So you yes, again you are coming back to. So what you have to do here is you have to stop that MySQL service there. Can you just go to that MySQL port number? What is the port number you are using over there?
3306, I guess. Not sure, sir.
Which one? MySQL or MariaDB 3306?
MySQL, sir. I'm not sure.
Okay, go to the new tab there. Go to your new tab on the browser.
Okay, sir.
Just phpMyAdmin you type. Localhost phpMyAdmin. Localhost phpMyAdmin. Just enter there. Oh, sorry, index is there.
Okay, I'll remove
this. No, leave it like that. Leave it like that. Server choice, you select MariaDB here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, root. Go. click go. This is the same problem actually. What even so here you have the database, your MySite one.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see, you are using, see the current server, what you are using, current database server, what you are using here is, what is written on the left side of your screen, the current server, the database server you are using is MariaDB. You are not using MySQL.
Yes, sir.
So, but the command, what the connection command, what you are seeing is basically for the MySQL.
Okay.
These are what you have given, the example is for MySQL only. So there are some small changes are there between MySQL and MySQL. But let us not change that commands here, because I don't want to confuse with two different set of commands. So students who have already started with MySQL, you proceed with MySQL. Let us now change this MySQL here. Go to your VAMP installation folder of your system. Let me just try for just quickly 2 minutes, then we'll see.
In the C drive,
sir. You have kept it in the C drive, your installation path. Yes. Go to your C drive. VAMP 64, you go there, double click there.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just select that .cunf file, configuration file, VAMP manager .cunf.
Yes, sir.
Right click it and open within your editor. You have a Notepad++ editor?
I actually am using Sublime Text, sir.
Open with Sublime Text, no problem.
Yes.
Can you scroll down, please? Go to the MySQL and MariaDB. Scroll down. That is PHP.
MySQL.
Hold on. Here it is there. Okay. So the MySQL port used is 3306. Come down, MariaDB, little bit. Scroll down. This is 3307. Have you changed this, or it was there like that only from the installation?
No, sir. I didn't change anything.
Okay. So just keep like that. Can you just come to the system tray at the bottom of your screen? In the system tray, go to that VAMP server. System tray, the right side bottom. System tray.
Okay.
No, system tray, not in the start front. System tray means here on the right side.
Okay, this one. Okay. Sorry, sir.
Right click it once. Hold on. Just put your cursor on the MySQL.
Yes, sir.
Just scroll down to MariaDB. Okay. So MariaDB is working 3307. It is fine only. MySQL, the problem is you already have the MySQL, already you installed it earlier, right?
Yes, sir.
So we need to make changes over there in that one. That we'll do at the end of the session. Kindly hold on, okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So that then your this MySQL commands can remain the same.
My.conf file also has all the same things, sir.
Sorry, which one?
My.conf file, this VAMP manager.conf file, this is also same thing is displayed for me also.
You are also the same thing, the same problem. Both of you, what you have done is you have installed MySQL independently before installing the VAMP server. Then later you have installed a VAMP server. VAMP server is by default, MariaDB has been selected for installation, but you might have selected again MySQL there. So the MySQL of the earlier version and this version of VAMP servers, because VAMP server is another container here. That container is running your another two different database servers here. If you have not done this MySQL installation earlier, earlier means before to the VAMP server, then this should be run fine. We can change the port numbers here. That should be fine for us. We can make use of this. But now, since you already have that MySQL port number conflict is there, that I'll check it closely. I will not waste time on this at this moment. But actually, the problem with her is, because she is able to use MariaDB here, but she's running the MySQL. The connection statement of MariaDB is a little bit different there, the methods. It is not simply the connect statement, MySQLi underscore connect. You have to run the DB query there. So because we are focusing on only MySQL, so let me not go into that little bit changes of to the MariaDB. Hold on, that we'll do that. This is only installation problem this is. We'll do it in the end of the session.
Okay.
Yeah, any other doubts, please, for anyone?
Should I stop sharing the screen, sir?
Yeah, you can stop your sharing the screen. Yeah. So what is the difference between PHP cookies and JavaScript cookies? Tarun, basically cookies are themselves small programs which have to be running. So basically on the client side. So JavaScript cookie is basically onto the client side. If you have a script file, which is basically a JavaScript file, and that script file is keeping storing certain values onto your local machine, that is at the client side. So basically, your local machine is your browser here. So that data, that is a temporary storage data. You can put some duration also for that. How long that cookie can be live. Or how the cookie can be set for that. So JavaScript cookies are basically those cookies, the small set of programs which run on the client side. PHP cookies, see, PHP is basically a server side program. Okay, even the server side program, some of those server side scripts, what happens is when you want to make, not to have a heavy load on the data transmission, you can make those cookies of that servers to be executed on the client side. If you want to have that feature where a light set of data can be stored on the local client machine itself, using the PHP script, you can also set as a global reference variable.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me just a little bit more explanation about it. Okay, Tarun. Eventually, cookies are to be stored on local machine, on the client's machine.
Yes, sir.
If you are modifying with JavaScript, JavaScript is going to run in your browser. From your browser, you are actually modifying the things which you store locally. Okay. That's about JavaScript cookies. Any server-side programming, if it basically either PHP or like like next week you will learn about Java servlets or JSP or whatever it is. If the server is trying to set up the cookie, so it will send the cookie through HTTP protocol and it will come to your browser and browser recognize that as the HTTP address, it will save or like it will be sending it back again. So eventually cookie is something stored locally by your browser. If it is modified by JavaScript, it is modified locally. Is by a server, it is coming to your machine through HTTP protocol and being modified by your browser. That's the short story about it.
But it's basically we select the cookies or something.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, like if you on JavaScript, if you are setting it up, then it is you are setting it. If the server is setting up, it is the server which is setting up. Even the JavaScript along with the file, along with your HTML is actually stored on the server. So right now, currently, you are storing it locally and then checking it. But eventually, everything will be set by the server itself, including the JavaScript as well. So knowing the big picture like that.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Sir, is the cookie stored in .php format in browser or in the server side?
Cookies are always stored local disk or in your memory. Okay, and it will be handled by your browser.
PHP cookie, it is a .php file?
Yeah, even if it is .php file, so if there is a cookie set, okay, the PHP file is actually at the server. So you are running the script at the server, and the server in response is actually sending you back the cookie in the form of HTTP protocol. It is coming to your browser, okay, and then it is stored there. So storage is always at the browser, and then either in browser's memory or in local file system.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, any other doubts, please? Assignment question 9, not clear, sir. Assignment question 9 assignment question 9 means assignment 3 only. Let me just open that assignment question 9 one second, please. Yeah, so last video meeting also we had the same discussion on this question. The design an email message interface system that satisfies the following requirements. What is the requirement here? Include two addresses in the to field. So once again, let me open here. If you see, when I compose, see, when I click a compose, what is that you are getting on the compose, please? Anyone? You, in the compose, you see there is a to. This is a text box is going to be there. You also have CC. You also have blind carbon copy. Carbon copy is there, blind carbon copy. Your subject is there. And below the subject, you have some body, or you are going to have a text area. So the recipients here, what happens is, how many recipients you can send here? Anyone? Can anyone answer this question? Two means basically it can be one user. Suppose I say like this, satish.srirama.uhvd.it. So this is one user here. Like this, I want to send to another user. Something like, again, satish.srirama with another ID. So here you have two IDs, two different IDs. Of course, the belonging to the same person here in this example, but it can be two or three or four or five or six. Can anyone say how many? There's a, is there any limit or is there is no limit? Usually, Sagiruddin, it is not only one. You can send. You might have send if you, when you are sending some emails, you should see. You'll be able to see many many two addresses can be there here. So, what is the difference between two CC and BCC? Anyone? What is the difference between to field and CC field and BCC field? If you want, please look to my first unit when I'm discussing the email I have given in my presentation, the difference between CC and BCC. Please look, listen to my video presentation, please. You'll get the difference between CC and BCC. Still, if you are unable to get that answer, that is on the first unit. When I'm discussing the email, introduction to email, I have given that difference between CC and BCC. Please go through it. I don't want to give that answer at this moment. First, you refer to that one and I'll get back to that answer. So here, when you are giving some two addresses, this question basically is asking for include two addresses in the to field of this message, separated by semicolon. So whenever you are entering some two addresses here, like this, I said, Satish, Sri Rama. It is one ID followed by semicolon. Here in the olden days, semicolon was the delimiter between the two addresses. Nowadays, you can see this when the email ID is correct, you'll get the correct format like this. But in the recent past, you might have seen some old email providers like your Hotmail or Yahoo, you might have seen they are separated by semicolons. So that was the early stages of development of new email settings. So that's what. Because you are designing your own email system here, email message interface system, you're designing and you're developing that your own interface system. I'm telling you, try to follow these features. So the two fields should be separated by the semicolon like this. So one is ABC and another is something like your own email address with two different email addresses. In the subject field, that is the subject field means the second tab or the second, this is the subject field. So this is the subject field here. What is that in the subject field should be? The subject field, enter the text. The text should be entered, something like assignment number 3, followed by your first and the last name. So here you are providing a text box. So the text box, this is the text box, subject field text box. In that you are providing this assignment number 3 belonging to so and so person. That's the meaning of this one. So that is what you need to do just to design. That's only a design. In the body of your message, introduce yourself. So there is the body of this message, the body, this is what below the subject. So there is a separator line is there between the two and the subject and the body. What is the separator line? Again, you please refer to my unit number 1, email introduction. So this you'll get the separator line also, information is there either. It means that's the email system the people have designed. This you need to follow the same principles. So in the body of your message, introduce yourself and let me know by what name you prefer to be addressed, something like this. Briefly describe, just put some text on that particular boxes. So this is what you have to design here. This is only designing. I did not say develop here. That's why listen to the question here. Design, not the development. When I say development means you have to write code. When you click the submit button, what should be happening for that? Whenever you click the send button, what should happen here? So I want to only design this interface. What you see it on my screen, the new message, some two address is there, subject is there. And to have it. So this is basically labels are there, text boxes are there, text areas are there. You need to design with the proper sizes with minimize, maximize. This is an interface system, just a user interface system. So that is the question that is asked, design only. When I say design and development means you need to write code for those things. So that questions you may see it in the assignment, the next assignment you see. So here in this assignments, you will usually see the interface only. And these interfaces like this, you see, create the following framework. Just creating this, you are not writing any codes for this one. Create a web page. So that is what create a website, designing this one. So that is just a design. You need to do it here, Sagirudhan. Is it clear? Okay, yeah, that's what. Any other doubts, please? So regarding the minor exams, we will get back to you on Monday's session. Maybe some update is there, will be there. So how do you proceed for that component evaluation? We'll discuss with you on Monday, most likely.
Regarding minor, like first we are discussing across the institute. So we'll try to converse something across all the courses. So that's why like we are not discussing it today.
Sir?
Yes, yes, Tarun.
So whenever we create a project like website or something with PHP and MySQL, so we need to put all those files in a folder which should be in like yesterday in the previous class you created it in /www something like that. So folder in that level only, that in that directory.
I see, it is not compulsory. What happens is your web server will look for the root directory. Root directory means what you have seen is basically something like this, /var/www/html is a common path, is a common folder. In fact, HTML is a common folder name. So www is your domain name, common name actually. So usually you have to inform to your web server where your root folder is there or your subdomain folder is there. So we said that in your web server configuration file will be there, whether you follow Apache or whether you follow Nginx or whether you follow IIS web server, means internet information server. So different types of web servers will have different means locations where your web resources are made available, so that your web server will always look for that particular folder. So that's why we this /var/www/html is a common means you, if you want to change with your name, you can change it and inform to your web server that my resources files are available on that. So whenever anybody types your domain name, that domain name is going to be mapped onto that root folder of my web resources. That is the meaning.
So what if we want to create the directory, our own project directory in some other location?
Yes, you can create it. What is, there is no wrong here. I think one student, actually I shown them, you see, he wants to have, I have shown for my site one. So he has given his own name, something like my dummy site, something like that. He has created the same folder there. And whenever you are accessing, see, something like this, see. Look on, are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See, usually when you go for, let me run my WAM server 1 second. So usually this is, see, this is my site one is there. This is my site one is my domain name, or my, I have created one folder here under the this local host. So if you see a PHP, let me open that. Sorry, 1 second. If you see the PHP information, what happens is that path here is, if you see here carefully, the document root path, this is the document root path.
Yes, sir.
You can change your document root path here. How do you change this document root path? Go to your WAM server. Okay. See here carefully. Are you looking to the my screen on the system tray?
Yes, sir.
On the bottom right side, you can see here httpd. That is what your Apache server name called as. .conf is there. Are you seeing this one?
Yes, sir.
Here you can open this file here. Okay. Now in this file, you can change these things. Your server file settings are here. Document root is here. Are you getting this point?
Yes, sir.
So the one which you have seen in the LAMP stack has got /var/www/html, but the WAMP has got this particular path.
Yes.
So, but both the meanings are same. Logically, technically, both are same. But this fellow, the WAMP server software, he is used this particular path. The LAMP stack, the open source technologies, they have used that particular path.
Yes.
But if you want to change, you have to change it in this file and restart your Apache server. That will be reflected here as a document root and put all your resources on the particular path.
Yes.
Actually, I want you to, after you develop this one, maybe after 1 week, just I'll give 1 more week for all of you to at least come up with the assignment 4. Once you complete assignment 4, I will make your websites to run on the internet. So that steps I will tell you. It will take one hour, at least half an hour session minimum. So that I will tell you, maybe next to next Monday, I will tell you how to up your websites onto your internet. As of now, you are running all things on your local host only, most of you, right?
Yes,
so now instead of local host, you can give your own names here. That I will tell you how to do that one. It's not very, and it is a free only, free of cost. So there is nothing, I will tell you how to put your domain name and how do you up your websites to, so that you can run. So before you up your own websites, you have to build up your own things, at least to some pages, at least should be there, so that it looks like good to see how you can do it. That's why just I'm waiting you to complete some exercises, at least by another one, we'll come back to that point. So that completes that second unit completely, and we'll be on to the other server side technologies in the next week.
So will there be any external libraries like in Python or in Node.js? We have npm install, we can use that, no sir, in PHP.
Node.js is what I already, the video is ready. NPM you are going to run now. Means server side JavaScript will be running. That's what your Node.js is. So that post I will put it by tomorrow.
Like, do we have that in PHP, sir? Like external libraries, can we include like that?
No, what do you mean external libraries here?
Like in Node, we can use some of the external through NPM, IE, body parsers like that, no, sir?
Yeah, that NPM, that's what your Node package manager, it will support the external. That's what the purpose of Node server is. PHP is not like that. PHP it itself is an independent parser that is. So if anybody wants to develop, they should be compatible to your existing PHP dependencies. So it should again depend on to the PHP. An independent external libraries you cannot connect here. Provided those API, they might have written some APIs, the connection strings, and they might have, they give, they can connect it. Otherwise, hello.
Yes, sir.
Are you there? Yeah. See, people develop some library routines. We call that as application programming interface APIs. Like those APIs are something methods which you will use it for your own application development, and that will enable you to connect to other sources like your external sources. What you are talking about.
Yes.
But what PHP does is, basically PHP is a parser. Parser means it has its own engine. The Zend engine, we call it as a Zend engine, Z-E-N-D. So that Zend engine, if anybody writes a compatible APIs with respect to that Zend engine, then the PHP will be able to run. Zend engine is a server actually that is running. So that should be compatible. And it is not that it's not independent. It is a very much dependencies are there, those things.
Okay, sir.
Sir, question sent by email is right. What is question sent by email, Sagiruddin? I did not get your point.
You might be talking about the previous one, sir.
That's what the one question you have sent me. Yes, yes. See, the question one you have sent is this one, Sagiruddin. Are you? I hope you are online. Yes, whatever you are designing is correct only. But once again, I reiterate, once again, I say that whenever you are incorporating certain features, whenever features for your user interface design, make proper things in the sense that, you see here, radio buttons also can be kept. You kept the checkboxes here. So there is a difference between checkboxes and radio button. Basically, a radio button is one, you can select one among them. But checkboxes, you can select multiple. Okay, so of course, in this example, we are not restricted here. So what I mean to say is,
checkbox, you told that a minimum five participant has to choose minimum five services. So I
yes, exactly. That's what I'm, you're right. You have put the checkboxes, you enable those five options there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In your JavaScript, at least yes, those options will be selected. Means I'm talking about one example. I'm telling, if somebody else keeps radio buttons, radio button is not the correct feature to be used there. You know why radio button cannot be used there? Just now I was telling to you, radio button is one among several. It means only one will be selected, not all five will be selected there. That's why radio button is not the correct feature to be shown there. Some students, to learn the features, they dump those design features, which is not correct in the software engineering terminology. Just to make you to understand, I was telling that. That's the only thing. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, any other doubts, please, for anyone? Amruta and Yashaswini, kindly hold on. Just we'll try to see in that one how do we can solve those issues for your installation process. So, yeah. If others have done, please, you can log out your sessions, please. I mean, you can disconnect your sessions. Yeah. I am using XAMPP. Yes, you can use it, no problem. We are not say we have to use XAMPP or LAMP. You can use Security, no problem. Yeah, so Amrutha, can you please share your screen if you don't mind? So let us check quickly how things goes on.
Sir, can you see my screen?
Yeah. So on that, your WAMP screen is okay. This is your WAMP manager configuration file. Fine. But on that day, the green color was shown, no? You're telling it is always orange? On that day,
yes, sir. That time, we stopped MySQL client. Then we started MySQL client again. Or I don't know. Suddenly, it became.
Okay, can you just restart one second?
It is starting now, sir. Now it's an orange, sir.
Okay, local server. Just right click it. Go to WAMP settings. Yes. So again, both of them are enabled. On that day, we have removed one, no? MySQL and MariaDB.
We removed MariaDB, sir. Now we allowed MariaDB.
That's what I'm telling. On that day, we have removed one option, but how come two options are enabled now?
We
just
removed
come on
it,
your phone. Yeah, no, I'm
no,
just
sir.
I'm just querying myself only. Just you know, I'm not asking you. Okay, anyway, whatever we have done on that day, that is, we disabled MariaDB, right?
Yes, sir. We disabled MariaDB.
Okay.
And we were using it, but it's still.
Can you just open your localhost on your new tab? This PHP
yes,
might
sir. Be. I don't know which one. MariaDB?
Already you disabled MariaDB, no?
Yes, sir. Index.
Some other settings have changed now. On that day, this has come actually. Okay, just go to again WAMP server, please. What is the status shown for MySQL here?
MySQL.
Hold on, status.
In
okay,
long,
this is, oh, one second. The interface has come here for you.
Yes, sir.
So this is. It is not
now
getting locked in.
Yes, sir. I disabled MariaDB. I have to stop MySQL again using the command line client.
No, don't stop here.
Yes, sir.
On that day, you said it needs to be run again, right, if I remember.
Yes, sir. We started it again.
So your 3306, your MySQL is only there. That is fine in your configuration file. Okay, just type enable MariaDB over there, and you type the port number 3307 here, please, once.
In command.
Don't stop anything here. Keep it like that on MySQL. Just minimize the screen. That's it. Minimize this command prompt. Please enable the MariaDB there. Enable that, and you type the 3307 port number here.
Okay, right click.
Yeah, warm settings. Enable this. No, here you just change the port number here on the URL. Localhost colon 3307. Press enter. Just refresh that. Okay, just restart WAMP server once. Restart all services. Restart all services. Click phpMyAdmin. 3307, there you type. Just change 3307 in this tab. I think the services are not running for you again. Once again, please can go to services. That services from your Windows. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Manage. Services and applications. Services and application. Yeah, double click. Services. Just go to MySQL.
MySQL 80.
Oh, that is okay. MySQL 80 is a 8th version only. MariaDB?
MariaDB isn't mentioned here. WAMP.
Okay.
WAMP, Apache, WAMP, MariaDB 64.
Oh, that is also running there. Oh.
MySQL ID 64 is not running.
So that's why that MySQL is not coming for you over there. Anyway, WAMP ADB 64 is running. At least that service has to. You are mentioning that you are continuing with that MariaDB, not then? Earlier.
Yes, sir. Earlier, yeah, MariaDB was opening on phpMyAdmin.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, maybe it will work again. Yes, sir. It's running on 3306, not 3307.
How come MariaDB we make to 3307? Just change the 330 and refresh there.
Here.
I think same MySQLD, the database server is just simply use the port number there. The database server may be same actually, the WAMP version. So there is a glitch here. Okay. Anyway, you will continue with this MariaDB only. Just 3306 when you continue there. Mm-hmm. So you are able to create the database. Sample one you have tested on that day.
Yes, sir.
What about PHP? Are you able to run this PHP on this one?
I haven't tried PHP, sir. So
PHP script you have not tried for this one?
No, sir.
Okay, can you go to the connection statement of your PHP? Can you run that?
I don't have it on my laptop. I didn't write any code so far. So
can you download my code from our course Internet Technologies page?
Yes,
maybe
sir.
Zip file will be there. Download just from our course file.
Sir, so where are we getting this database from, sir?
Which database, ma?
MySQL. We have used some commands, no sir. Like connected successfully or disconnected. So where are we storing those username and password actually?
What do you mean by storing again? I did not get your point.
Like we should need some database, no sir. We are storing it there.
In the database server, we should need some. Yes, that's what she has not written any program there. I'm asking her to at least start with my.
Like in general, PHP MyAdmin is providing for us, no sir. Like database should consist of some space, no sir.
PHP MyAdmin is just a manager for your database. Is an administrator. You download this my site 1.zip file, ma.
Yes, sir.
Tarun, yes. See, basically, your doubt is what is PHP MyAdmin is doing, huh?
That no, sir. Like, where are we exactly storing these variables and all, sir? So, we were comparing username and password from the database, no, sir. From the form fields, and we were comparing with form data with the database stored values. No?
Just hold on. Let me. I do not get your point still. You unzip that file, Amma. Just Tarun, just hold on. Let me. I'm just get back to you. So put this particular file.
What is it called again? Source code.
No. What is it you're looking for?
My site.
My site one. Okay. That name of that folder.
I think I didn't extract it.
It will be in your downloads folder, Amma.
This also I should extract them.
What are you doing, Amma? Just hold on.
No, I was just wondering if I could open using Visual.
Copy that folder. Copy that folder. Copy the folder as it is. Copy the folder. Go to your WAMP installation drive. Amma, Shesuni Rupa, you are looking onto this thing because your problem is also related to this only. Yeah.
Yes, sir. WAMP
installation drive.
So, just www folder will go there. Go to the www folder. Paste there. Paste the folder there.
Yes, sir.
Now you go to your localhost on the URL.
Here, sir.
Local. Just type localhost. V1000 is coming here.
That was earlier for some other website. Localhost refused to connect.
Go top. V306 with the database, okay. Select my site one. Select my site one.
Oh, here.
It's not coming?
No, sir.
Okay. So you need to go to your virtual host settings of this one. So this VAM server, the latest one, this one, a lot of. Okay.
Virtual host.
Yeah, /etc/host under that. Add your folder name, Amma.
Which folder name?
Okay, instead of that my site one, for testing only, you just copy all your files onto that www folder. It will come to my site one in the latest.
Here, www.
Double click that folder, my site one. Oh, inside that one more my site one is there. Huh? Oh, you are extracting it. Okay. Copy all the files. Copy all the files. Bring it to www folder. Yes. Paste it there. Later, we'll create the folder and you can keep it later. So now just go to your URL.
Localhost, sir.
Yeah. Just refresh. You type login.html there after the port number. Hold on. Now you go to configuration file. You will not connect here because we did not give the database username password properly. Go to connect.php. Open the connect.php. In the www folder only, the same folder. You have connect.php there. Yes. Open the editor. Amma, Yashasvini Rupa, have you changed this one? What I am telling now? Open with the editor. Okay, now your database name, what is the database name you use there?
Database. I don't
sample
know.
One or something you have used there, ma. Go to your PHP admin.
So
what is the database name you are using here? Sample one. Click the sample one. Oh, there is another test. No, on that day we created one database, Kadamma.
Test.
No. Go to test.
Yes, sir.
No, why you are clicking SQL? No. If you click test, click. No, user. Some users you have created. No, you have not created any users there.
Yes, sir. In this one, we created. It was just
The database name is sample one, and the table name is test one. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And you are looking for what? That is, okay, something like number and name. Okay. See, what are your field names here?
Number and name
class section is there. Okay. So remember this thing. The database. What is your database name? Sample one.
Sample.
What is your table name?
Test one.
And what is that you're looking for now? Number and name. Okay, now come back to our connect.php file. Here you change to sample one. That is your database name. You have to change these settings. Sample one. Okay. We are not given any password to the root, right?
No, sir.
Okay, save that file.
Saved. But it is MySQLi underscore connect, no, sir, here.
MariaDB also supports that. MySQLi underscore connect. It will support it. MariaDB will support it. No, hold on. Still, it is not over. Go to that authentication.php file.
Authentication.php. Authentication.php.
Select star from test one.
Test one.
Where number is equal to okay, whatever it may be, that is your that variable name there, and you are given number and a name, and instead of password, you give it as a name here. Okay, now go to your login.html, save this file. Go to login.html. Visual Studio Code, ma.
Yes, sir. It's not listed there.
There. It is there. Microsoft Visual Studio is there, ma.
Visual Studio is different. Visual Studio Code is different, sir.
Yes, both are different. But why? You can use it with any editor. That's not a problem.
Yes, sir. But I prefer Visual Studio Code, sir.
Here you change to number and name. Instead of user and pass, you change to number and name. Label is okay anyway. Label is not the problem.
ID we should change, sir.
Sir, we can Ashwini, what is that you are asking? We can open localhost my site one. Are you able to open that one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. After the database connection, you're not able to come up?
Yes, sir. I mean, if I put the username and password and I click on login, the warnings were coming, sir.
That's what have you changed this? Whatever the settings we have done now in the connect page and in the authentication page, have you changed according to your database name?
Yes, sir, the same code as you gave in the Moodle, sir. That is the thing which I run.
Okay. Same code only, but the database?
Yes, sir, same thing, sir.
Have you created the database?
Yes, sir.
Created the same table name?
Yes, sir.
Same two column names?
Yes, sir.
So your problem is with that MariaDB and MySQL only. That will be okay. Save this file and open this login.html again in the URL,
sir. But if she changes in HTML, we should also change in authentication.php. No, sir.
What has to be changed in the authentication.php? What in she has changed here?
Here we are taking user and pass. No, sir.
Those two things have to be changed here.
Yes, it should be number and name.
Sorry, login.html. Same ID, how can you give for both of them? Number or name? So you are given number and name. Okay. I thought it is name.
Sir, the dollar underscore will take the name attribute of the form, no, sir?
Yes.
Then there it was only user and pass.
Where?
In the login.html. It is still user and pass in the name attributes.
Can you open the code, Amma? Where?
Sir, name.
The name, name you changed to number and name, Amma. These values has to be changed to your authentication, whatever the page. These are going to be referred there.
Sir, is it referred by ID or is it referred
no,
by...
No, ID is only to this current web page.
Okay, sir.
Name.
If you are this ID is referring to those web objects, that current page web objects only.
Uh-huh.
Where are you now? Where are you? Save this program. Go to that web page. Yeah, refresh this web page once. Whatever the name, number and name you are given there in your database, just check it with first.
Waiting for localhost.
Can you go to your tools there, right side, developer tools on the web page? More tools, yes. Developer tools, yeah. The server's problem only. Hello, Ashish. I'm in a meeting. Can you just hold on? Amis, is it okay? Can you connect after 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Just hold on. I'll connect after 10, 15 minutes. Okay. There is a problem. Here, the method is MySQL. It is not connecting to your MySQL database. The problem is with you, your MySQL is not running there. That is the only problem here. But I thought it would be able to run onto your MariaDB. But even that is not supporting. Then instead of changing the methods, let us see for MySQL database server to run. That is the only remedy for us. Instead of going to that one, you have to come again from your services now.
Services.
Can you just do one thing, Amma? Don't change anything now. Just tell me step by step once again. Minimize the screen.
Mm-hmm.
Go to your phpMyAdmin. There we started with MySQL option there. In that, can you open that MySQL option of your WAMP server? No, this is MariaDB anyway. Keep it like that. The current server is MariaDB only. No, you go back to this. Go back. Press the back button of this only. Yeah. Still further back. Go back, go to the initial one. Still, hold on. Select MySQL there. Yeah, click go. Yes, Ashwini, you can uninstall it and reinstall, but they don't want to do that. That is the thing. Usually, because this is a configuration steps, we have to change the configuration files. But I'm just trying not to waste the further time. That's what the port number has to be. This is a port number conflict only from the beginning. Okay, Amma, just I think no, don't do anything here, Amma. One thing I better prefer. Can't you uninstall this? Oh, hold on. WAMP version you are using? WAMP?
WAMP version.
Can you, if you don't mind, hello, are you able to hear my voice, ma?
Yes, sir.
Amruta and Yashaswini.
No.
Yashaswini, are you online?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so what I suggest you is, you are using WAMP 3.2, right?
Yes, sir.
Because this latest version of WAMP is having MySQL and MariaDB both together, and there is an option to select one of them. That is they are giving, but for your laptops, it is creating any problem. But for we will not go very much in the database administrations. So you need to practice these commands very quickly, and because we have so many other tasks to be done. So what I prefer to you, can you search for this one, pump server. Search for. Version number is around 2.something.
2.something.
Around 2.5 or
2.5.
2.5
is there, sir.
2.5 is there, is able to download for you?
I mean, it is giving 2.5 free download.
2.5 is WAMP or all free downloads only. This is open source only.
Yes, sir, it is.
SourceForge, from SourceForge you can download it, Amma. No problem.
Yes, sir. WAMP server 2.5, Apache 2.4.9.
Okay. So what I suggest to you is, you please uninstall this WAMP, whatever you have, the 3.2 version. And okay. You can, MySQL 5.6 is there, PHP 5.5. That is enough, Amma. That you'll have the latest functions at least. Because the latest one is PHP 7 and above is the latest. Of course, MySQL 8 is also there. But for our course works, we can practice with the whatever the functionalities with these versions are there. So mostly, so you please download this one. But before installing, you need to have a clean uninstall of your previous WAMP and as well as the MySQL. Okay. And anyway, you might have installed your Microsoft Visual C++, this one, runtime library, yes. Both of you, right? It might have installed, then only you'll be able to install that WAMP. So already that prerequisite, you might have installed it. But just for curiosity, I'm asking, why don't you go for LAMP instead of WAMP?
We could install. You're
not practicing on a Linux environment.
We could install LAMP, sir. We just thought, since I'm using Windows.
Yes, that WAMP, that is the latest version of WAMP is having port conflicts, problems will be there. That's what I could search it from the internet also. Many people have faced that one. So better not to go for that. Why you need to have trouble yourself?
Sir, can I use it on Windows subsystem for Linux?
Windows subsystem, because later you have Ruby on Rails somehow. The later part will be there. That is another biggest installation. The immediate parts are your Node.js has to be installed, your JDBC has to be, drivers has to be installed. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So
and Node is installed on Windows. I can install it again
Node.js you can install on Windows as well as Linux also. That is not a problem. But I'm talking about Ruby. That comes later stage. Anyway, you will be using Windows now. That is fine. So you have to install the MongoDB also. Node.js and MongoDB, the immediate next installation for the next week. After
I have MongoDB.
MongoDB. Oh, okay, then you can continue, Amma. That's not a problem. But better you have a clean installation of this 2.5. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Instead of, you please remove that one. Again, I need to spend a lot of time on that one. Let us complete as quickly as possible.
Okay.
Is it okay?
So I should uninstall previous MySQL and
WAMP also. So you please uninstall all your things and delete your folders also.
Yes,
of
sir.
WAMP as well as the MySQL folder if you have installed earlier.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that is a clean installation.
Okay, sir. So should we uninstall both WAMP and MySQL?
Yes. See, once you uninstall WAMP, automatically the WAMP's container MySQL will be uninstalled. But since you said that you have installed MySQL already there, so that path will be there in your Windows operating system. Are you getting this point?
Yes, sir.
That also you need to delete it. So after you clean and uninstall all those.
Okay, sir.
Then you please install WAMP 2.5 or 2.6, whatever it may be, it can be downloadable to you. That is enough for us. Most likely those, because that will not have port conflict problems.
Okay.
That WAMP 2.5 will have only one database server, MySQL only. It will not have MariaDB.
Hmm.
And that is for your database course also, it will be useful for you. Because MySQL is required for you. So that is better. Otherwise, again, you have to change the methods and other things. Okay, just try for this and please let me know at least by Saturday or Sunday, okay? Both of you.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, I will check it on Sunday afternoon and I'll get back to you on Monday. So, okay? Yeah. Right. Okay, yes, take care, Amma.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, Amma. Okay, bye. Take care. Bye.